not such a type of people who can just drink only air. We can drink only air and we can dwell in the forest. We can stand up in the fire and to do continuous penance for millennia together. It is not possible for limited and capricious human beings like us. So we are of a different type. We are educated in an institution. We are organized in such a systematic way, non-systematically or parasystematically or ultra-systematically, we cannot get anything. So the great years, even though there are Sakshatkara, Upadesha and Adhyana Parampara. What is Sakshatkara? Those people, those who have seen the God, those who have seen the Vedas, those who have been manipulated by the vibrant, radiant penetrations of the Vedic vision and Vedic attunement, such persons, they need not feed the same thing to the infraspecial characters which existed in those period. Just as even the mother well grown for a newborn babe, it shall give a lactal concern or it can give a masticated or well crushed food, pattering to that of the digestibility of the assimilation skill of the child, not based on the capability or personal capability of the mother. Likewise, even though the seers, they have been engaged in the process of transcendental understanding, as they clearly know that their coexisting members of the society as well as the forthcoming generations will not be totally eligible to either enter into or enroll into or to at least be a good receptacle of this transcendental wisdom, they created institution. So the knowledgeable people, they have created, they have institutionalized. First they have conceptualized, then they have visualized, then they have visualized. The same thing has been put into such a digestible format as an institution. Now we are in the Vidvat Parampara. So we have Shastras. Starting from the Vedas, Atharva Veda, Rig Veda, Shatapatha Brahmana, Gopatha Brahmana, ending with Vedangas, which are the basic framework of astrology or astronomy, on the basis of which Jyotisha Sutras, like Jaimini Sutra, Bhrigu Sutra, etc. Then we have Vrittis, Bhashyas, Vivaranas, Kavyas, Akhyatas, then Anusandhana Granthas, with innumerable Tika, Vivarana and Tipani. So this is known as Vidvat Parampara. So apart from this, we have Vrikshashastra, Megha Vijnana, Sasya Vijnana, then Bhukampa Vijnana, Jalakampa Vijnana, Utpada Vijnana, innumerable things of prediction, not only pertaining to human beings. If it is Manushika, it is for human. If it is Divya, it is for predicting the divine will or divine execution in the world. If it is Bhaudika or Bhaumika, it deals with earth, the whole globe, the meteorological influence, influence of comets, astral bodies, satellites and various zonal variations that happens in the firmament in the form of celestial engineering. It is known as celestial mechanics. So that is known as Bhautika or Bhoumika. Then there are also innumerable things for the infrastructural standards such as Prani Vijnana, Krimi Vijnana, Kita Vijnana, Sasya Vijnana, which is in botany. The science is known as Krishi Parasara. So starting with an amoeba, ending with Brahma, each and everybody, they have a karmic bondage and there is a science to interpret it. So this is the lineage. Now we are in the institutional standard because we have Shastras, we have Gurus, we have Parampara, we have Abhyasa, we have Adhyayana, Sikshana, Abhyasa, Palana. Now immediately, as soon as they get a translation work or something, immediately they start into the very hazardous work of interpreting either for themselves or for others. This is just like a person who is just a tailor getting into the hazardous task of doing surgery, thinking that both of them are operating with the same thread and needle. It is not like that. So, interpretation for his own self. There are areas for Jyotisha. First is Vividisha. Desire to know about things. It is based on inquisitiveness. That is Vividisha. Swarakshana. To make a principled way of life. It is self-governance or life management. You are studying MBA in hospital management. Then there is a finance management, human resource management, everything. If you are not managing your own life and wife, how you are going to manage other things? So, astrology is a life management science. It is Swarakshana. That is the second thing. Third is Bodhana. It is for teaching others. Fourth is Prabodhana. To create awareness in the society. Fifth is Anusandhana. Research. Sixth is Margadarshana or astrological profession. The profession of astrologer is not just foretelling or something or telling the stories of the future and past. The real work of astrology is Margadarshana. Just as a medical practitioner, he knows physiology, anatomy and pathology, he aids the person in physical salubrity. A psychiatrist does with mental counseling. A doctor deals with the body and a spiritual doctor deals with the emancipation of the soul. So he is a life doctor. Astrologer is a life doctor. He deals with the person's various bhavas, starting with his life, his eloquence, his standard, his family, his knowledge. So starting with a person's spiritual, mental, emotional, sensational, social, matrimonial, educational, professional, national, global, political, economical, various spheres by a person, and he manages that. The management is only capable by means of a proper, vigilant, meticulous, knowledgeable guidance of an able, compatibly competent person with the transcendental vigor, valor, glamour and color. Such a person is known as an astrologer. He is a margadarshaka, and the purpose of astrology is margadarshana. So six people: Vibhishan, aspirant of astrology; Swarakshana, one who wants to guide himself, put in proper track. Then the Bodhana, teaching. Fourth is Prabodhana, awareness, just as they are doing, that is Prabodhana. Then Anusandhana, research. Certainly if you want to create awareness, you have to do research. Sixth is Margadarshana, that is astrological practice. This is how we have to read. See, lot of things are there. That is the reason, because only if you know from the fundamental Vedas, you can have a closer vision, global vision, deeper vision and wider vision of astrology. Knowing astrology as an astrologer, interpreting astrology as an astrologer, is entirely different from a person who is in the very pursuit of interpreting astrology. Because that gives, I have already told, wider, deeper, broader, brighter, transcendental, refulgent, radiant and brilliant version of the inner meanings, the unfathomable regions can be well covered only by a Vedic perspective. So based on these shastras, lot of shastras they came into existence. Intuitive, instinctive and institutional. It does not mean that institutional do not have this intuitive or instinctive. Everything starts with instinction. Second, it must be well nourished by intuition. Then only it must be institutionalized. Now mere institutional education is totally insufficient for us for interpretation of scriptures or a person's horoscope. They must have, we used to say it is known as tripad. The person must have good instinct of belief, honesty and various other factors. Then he is one-third astrologer. Second, he must have intuition by means of spiritual practices. Then he must have the institutional benefits of getting, I belong to the Saravaji school, Phaladipika school, Krishnamurti Paddhati. Those things are institutional later. They must be governed by the beams, the supporting beams of intuitive perfection, which must be well founded by the foundation, substratum of instinctive precision. So instinctive precision results in intuitional perfection, which will result in infallible prediction of your institutional knowledge and theory. Without that, it is incomplete. It is dangerous. We used to say these things are very dangerous. That will result in four types of astrological predictions. One is ekapakshiya. You will be unidimensional. That will be very great harm to the person who is believing you. Second is vipaksha. It will be having a contrary prediction. Third thing is tirodhana, which we discussed on that day at our seminar. Tirodhana. Even if a person is having shruti, scriptural knowledge, yukti, comparison or logical view, Ganita, calculus, and Anubhava, experience in both these things, or three of these things, still he must have a Siddhi, accomplishment of divine knowledge or divine spirit. Without which, whenever you are seeing an horoscope for comparison, either for a matrimonial match or for any decision making, if you are seeing, you cannot see that particular combination which gives the particular effect. After the thing has happened, that is, when the future has become the past, then the combination will appear for you. Why you could not see the same? Because that is Tirodhana. That is a screen which curtains your vision. And this screen cannot be removed, even imagined to be removed, by your scriptural knowledge, by your calculus experience or experimentation, or by your inference, or by the other skills of your logical, statistical, strategic and logistic views. They cannot come for your rescue. Only by Siddhi. So Tirodhana is total curtaining. It is Kakatadiya. If your jataka, if your horoscope is good, whatever you may just vomit or whatever you may bluffer, immediately it will become the truth. That is kakatadiya. It is an accidental precision. So if a person is not there with these skills, the precision will be either unidimensional or contradimensional or total nescience or cutting, or it may be coincidental. It is because of your horoscope and its benefits that particular period, whatever, just bluff, everything will come as a formula, a very great prediction. So we know very clearly, because most of the people are having their shops only by the benefit of Kakatadiya Swami. The other things, they don't exist in the society at all. Most of the people. Who is having Vividisha? There are only two types of astrologers, I used to say. Those who